In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Holy words, long preserved for our walk in this world. They resound with God's own heart.
For our goodnight message on this Saturday, the 21st of May 2022, broadcasting from the Salesian Pontifical University, Rome, Italy, by your servant Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco, we listen to this life-changing lesson entitled, How to Take Every Thought Captive, Healthy Christian Mindset. Today we are living in a world which is making us have too many things to think about. This has led to a lot of depressive feelings in many people, which has resulted to cases of suicide in many of our young people, even in grown-ups. But when you listen often to goodnight messages, you move away from such imprisoning thoughts. What does it mean to take every thought captive? How do you develop a healthy Christian mindset? You have, first of all, to understand that your mind is one of the most powerful parts of who you are. Spiritual battles are won and lost in the mind. Your thoughts determine your actions every single time. It's pretty trendy to talk about how your mindset matters these days, and all those who talk about it are not wrong. It's so important. God talks to us about it in the Word and tells us how to master our Christian mindset. We are commanded in Scripture to take every thought captive. But what does this mean? Paul states that he and his fellow workers in the ministry destroy arguments and every lofty opinion raised against the knowledge of God, and take every thought captive to obey Christ. 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 5. Before we can dive in the meaning of the phrase take every thought captive to obey Christ, we must first look at the context of this statement. When Paul wrote his second letter to the Corinthians, he was writing to a congregation that was up to their neck in trouble. A group of false teachers had come into the church and had swayed a majority of the congregation against Paul and toward their own beliefs. They had presented letters of recommendation, which coupled with their flashy personalities and grand words, made them appear to be wonderful leaders with great power and authority. And the people followed them without question. Paul, deeply concerned about the situation currently brewing, wrote to defend his authority and teachings. In the first few verses of chapter 10, he urges the church to heed his words so that he would not have to be bored on the next trip to see them. He then uses war imagery, invoking terms such as stronghold and take captive to convey the reality that his ministry was a spiritual battle of confronting worldviews and beliefs that are set against God and ensuring that in their place are beliefs and thoughts that are in obedience to Christ. So getting to know this background will help us also to know how to apply this concept in our own day-to-day living. We are under attack by many worrying situations that are holding us captives. Any time at all you have a thought that threatens God's authority in your life or leads you away from a life of total dependence on God, you must take it captive and cast it down. Your thoughts may be hidden from sight for now, but they are very powerful and will indeed direct the course of your life. In order to take captive your thoughts, your negative thoughts, you have to replace them forcefully by good thoughts. Philippians chapter 4 verse 8 says, "Finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things." A mind filled with things that reflect his character, which is good, just, pure, excellent, and worthy of praise. A life that is submitted to God. Knowing what it means to take every thought captive still doesn't help you to have a healthy Christian mindset. To do that, you have to be very intentional. Colossians chapter 3 verse 1 to 3 says, "If then you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God." This passage echoes the instructions of Jesus in Matthew chapter 6 verse 33 to seek the kingdom of God first and his righteousness. Let us ask that you hang with me. It is his word and his work that should be the centerpiece of our lives and the forefront of our minds. When we focus on him, we will not have any negative feeling or any negative thinking in our minds. We shall be filled with hope. We shall be filled with confidence to face anything that comes our way. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, as it dreams.
Same to you, Father.